for a sign, and in return, a vow to one day build a shrine.
There's a light that glows by the front door. Don't forget the keys under the mat. When childhood stars shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can.
Don't waste time.
Always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. Know the difference between sleeping with someone and sleeping with someone.
David Yang is all ready for retirement with his cup of coffee in the morning and his flannel. Oh, David Yang.
Stay humble and kind.
Ready to retire, David Yang?
shut off the AC and roll the windows down. Let that summer sunshine always stay humble and kind. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget, turn back around. Help the next
one. That's like my snowboarder shades.
Always stay humble and kind.
Now. Good morning, Tisha. Good morning, Ava. Come on, a couple more minutes, guys. Couple more minutes here. It's 8:02. Give everyone till about 8:04, 8:05. Great song right here.
turned on the evening news, saw an old man being interviewed, turning 102 today. They asked him, what's the secret to life? He looked up from his old pipe, laughed and said, all I can say is, don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap and you wake up and you're 25. Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink. You just might miss your babies growing like mine did. Turning into moms and dads, next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you pray and God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think.
All right. All right. Good morning, everyone. Hopefully everybody's doing good. Hopefully everyone had a good weekend. We are only sitting at about 43 people in here, which really concerns me because there's been some things happening lately. Let me take off this stupid filter so you guys don't. Guys, there's some things that we got to understand as far as Canvas. Now, I got a lot of emails this weekend, okay, and a lot of stuff. And I apologize for confusing you on assignments too. I put half of that on me, but I put half of that on you. Okay. I put the half on me where I haven't before had multiple assignments going for different classes in the same course, which is something I didn't plan to do, but it's something that happened. And I'm not, but the part on you is you guys weren't following simple instructions from the start. I always told you to look at the main Canvas page. A lot of you guys are depending on the calendar. Let me show you right now the difference in those so we understand, okay? And this is probably for a lot of your other classes too. Right now, you should be able to see my Canvas page, okay? If I go to home right here and I go to classwork and I go to week 13 last week, okay? And if you go down to the assignment I got emailed on a lot down here on Friday, you will notice the trainer instructional Flipgrid videos, period 3 and 4 only. Okay. You guys, believe it or not, none of you are in period 3 or 4. Okay. So if you emailed me asking me about this, okay, I kind of get frustrated, partly because it's something new we done, but the other part is that was only for period 3 and 4. Now, what you guys saw, and I get it 100%, is you guys are going and you guys are depending on the calendar. I get that 100%. You guys are going to the calendar, you're coming down here, and you see on the calendar fitness and conditioning. I get it. You click on your fitness and conditioning class, and you saw this trainer instructional Flipgrid video over here. I get that. Okay, I get that. Now, this won't happen again, okay, because now we're doing the same thing. But, guys, some of you guys had important emails to me that I didn't get back to you, like a couple of you inherited injuries and stuff like that. Because I had too many emails that it was frustrating to respond to, okay? But what I will tell you guys is, depend on the Canvas site, not the calendar. Like, for example, I noticed when I went to the calendar that I've been horrible about updating the Zoom meetings and moving those over, okay? I've been horrible. I just moved your class over, so it should be pretty easy for tomorrow. But I've been horrible. So if you're depending on the calendar, guys, you take a chance of missing something. Now, on the other hand, some of you took initiative and still did the instructional video. I am not going to watch those, okay? Because that is going to be one of our culminating assignments right now. So you just got extra practice on that. All right? Are we good on that? I'm going to look at all of you. Give me a thumbs up if we're good. Always look at the Canvas site, okay? Now, on the other hand, I'm not mad at you guys because I appreciate you guys being proactive on that. But I spend a lot of time, and this week you're going to notice if we look at this week, week 14, because it's a little bit, why am I in quarter one? My bad. If you guys look in the Canvas site for this week, I did a little bit more to try to make it easier. Like, for example, you will notice one thing I added in right here is items to do, daily task to turn it in. Okay. So what we're doing that day and what you're turning in. All right. So if you guys look at that, that's one thing that it is. And then, like, you'll see Tuesday agenda, items to do, items to turn it in. Wednesday to do, turn it in. Okay, so I tried to make that a lot easier for you guys, too. And down here, guys, obviously, you have every day what you should do. I changed this up a little bit. We're going to change it up this week. Thursday, we are not going to Zoom. And for a couple reasons. One, I might be on a plane. I might not be on a plane at that time. During this course, okay, I might be able to make it, but so I created this assignment, which you guys can do. You're going to do your self-made workout, which you need to do anyways before we do in groups. I thought about that this weekend when I had an exercise group that I lead do a workout that I didn't do, and it absolutely was not difficult at all, and I was upset because this is a really workout-orientated group. Okay, so you see each day what's the items for that day. Okay, and obviously your infographic on an exercise that we're going to talk about next is a week-long activity. Obviously, you could do a little bit each day, or you could finish it all today or tomorrow and turn it. All right, are we good? I got off my little rant. Guys, I just get frustrated because I spend a lot of time trying to make this all good for you guys. Okay, again, I see a lot of people on here, and a lot of you guys aren't turning in assignments. I do not understand what the malfunction is, and I know I'm talking about 15% of you guys. I got to send out progress reports this week, and I have about 4 people in this class that are failing the class. Those people, some things align. One thing is they never turn on their camera. Okay, that is really frustrating. Okay, if you're here, I've given you your points for the week, but they never turn on their camera. Okay, so if you're a difference between, like, let me tell you how teachers work a little bit. If you end up with like a 69.3%, traditionally teachers aren't going to round it. But if you're someone here that's every day with your camera on and we know we're putting in effort, we're probably going to give you the benefit of the doubt, round that up to a C. Okay. If you're a student that's like at a 58% and you never have your camera on, we're not going to give you an opportunity to do extra credit or do anything like that. So those of you that don't have your camera on right now, I understand some of you have camera issues. I understand some of you guys woke up, but you have a responsibility to this course to do the things right. Okay, and this is that accountability piece where I owe it to you guys to hold you accountable to do the right thing, okay? I understand you might not look good. I just ran home in the rain because it is raining downtown. I don't know if it's raining there, to make it to this class on time, and I still have my camera on with my nice, beautiful locks of love hair. See that? Thank you for laughing at me, Brian. I appreciate that.
Yes.
Okay, moving on, guys. We're going to talk about this week's assignment, okay? Very similar to last week, but we're going to do an infographic on an exercise, okay? No, you don't have to complete the trainer instructional flip grid, Josie. I apologize for that. Okay, so boys and girls, so this week you're going to complete an infographic on an exercise, okay? You are going to analyze the exercise to a T, and it looks like we have 2 examples for you here, okay? And I'm going to pull one up right now that I did, and then I'll pull the second one up. Guys, wouldn't it help if I start this class at 8:15? Because I feel like so many kids are late. If I was your employer right now, I'd fire all of you. And let's go back because I am on a tangent of trying to help kids today. Let me see all of you smile. So I'm going to go back to a little resource that I made a long time ago because I'm commonly going to hear technology issues. And that thing that I'm, that, whoa, where'd I put it? Did I let you guys down? Did I not put it in here? And it's, it must have been in week 10. Darn it, I should have put it in there. If we look at week 10, and we look at this little thing right here that says, um, Okay, I don't know what I had in my PowerPoint. How to be successful in my class. One is check technology issues at the start. So we should never have technology issues. Okay, off my tangent. Here we go. All right, so guys, week 14. We infographic this week on an exercise. I am going to share mine right now that I did for you guys. And then we'll share the one it looks like that Coach K did for you guys. So if we go here, we look at mine. I did probably what I consider the hardest exercise to explain and demonstrate on an infographic. The bottom line and the rubric for this infographic is you need to be able to take the exercise, break it down, where you could show that as a personal trainer to a client that might be able to look at something and analyze it a little bit. Someone that learns in that mechanism, be able to do it. So I did the burpee, as you can see on your screen. Give me a thumbs up if you can see my burpee on here. Can you see my burpee? Okay. So I did the burpee. Okay. So I put burpee, the breaking down the burpee movement. Okay. You can put whatever. You could put like push up, the chest sculptor or whatever exercise. You can name the exercise whatever you want. I then did a brief description of the burpee. I put the burpee as a full body exercise, which encompasses many other movements into one in order to complete the final product. And I started with movement one. I talked about the squat. Key points are hips back and knees do not go over toes. Then I talked about the sprawl. Hands come down to the ground and feet kick back to a push-up position. Then I talked about the push-up. Lower yourself down to the ground, then back up. And then the reverse sprawl. Okay, there's the sprawl from the squat position, and then there's a reverse sprawl from the push-up position. Jump the feet back under the hands in the bottom of the squat position. Then I talked about jump from bottom of squat position. Explode up, making the feet leave the ground. And then I put burpees key to success, form over speed, start, as I say, off, obviously spelling error, I would lose 1 point because I'm a failure. Start off making sure every movement is correct and doing one good one is better than five bad ones. Practice the individual movements before doing them all together. One must be able to do a squat, a sprawl, a push-up, and a jump squat first. The burpee is a good exercise to focus on muscular endurance and cardiovascular endurance. The muscles worked in a burpee are the following. And I put two infographics here, but then I put the main muscles work throughout the whole burpee. So you don't find many other exercises where you get this many main muscle groups working through the idea of a burpee. Okay, let's go on to the one Coach K made real quick, because I think this is good because I haven't even been back on my Canvas site to look at this, so I get to learn too. So if we go right here to the jump squat. Okay. And let me share my screen. Where is my little icon that seems to leave me every now and then? Okay. Talking about the jump squat, okay, we have a nice little exercise thing here, the jump squat. A step-by-step display of how to do a jump squat. A jump squat is a plyometric movement that targets the legs and is also great for cardiovascular endurance. Great intro to the exercise as far as what it could work. Plant feet a little wider than shoulder width apart. Toes are pointed forward and hands begin at your sides. Begin to move down into the squat. Send hips back, keep weight in heels. Push weight all the way back to get a nice and low in the squat, bring your arms forward into prayer hands. Keep knees in line with toes, head facing forward, jump up. Boom, drive through the legs, explode straight up in the air, jump as high as you can, swing, push those arms back. Long momentum, head returns face forward. Boom, land back down on the ground and return to the squat position. Gently land, leaning the feet into starting position, trans back. Then begin the jump squat again. For an effective leg workout, repeat this as many times as you can. Very good. Muscles worked in the jump squat. Diagram here and the muscles worked. Very, very good. We should also be aligning and learning based on seeing these muscles, knowing where they are located on the body. That's kind of our next step, is understanding the movement of the body and how we do that. Any questions so far? Any questions so far?
I do.
Go ahead, Brian.
What size is the graph about the burpees and jump squats?
What do you mean, what size is the graph? I took it from one of those two.
The wide and width.
Take a template off one of those sites. I know some of you guys on your infographic last time did it a little bit differently, which is fine. But those two sites have templates you could use. That's why I picked them. So take one of the templates. Like I could see me and Coach K both used a template from there that we both used a very similar template. It's called on Canva, it's called the infographic template. And that's the one I like to do because it's chronological to tell a story. So just use that template off that website. Does that make sense, Brian? Okay. Are we good with that? Okay. Key points, this needs to happen. Now I have this. If we go back to our Canvas page and we go down, I'm going to guide you through where I'm going so you can see. So if we're on our Canvas page and we go down to where we turn it in, okay, right here's the key points, what your graph must include. Design an infographic of an exercise. Again, I need to slow down and spell correctly. I apologize, guys. That's not very good practice as a teacher. And also, I blame it that why does Canvas not have spell check? Huh? You tell me that. Okay, so infographics must be of an exercise picked from the Google Sheet form. I'll talk about that again. Must include example of the movement in image form, okay? Some of you guys last time turned in movements, but you didn't turn in images. I want images, okay? That's an infographic, okay? You are telling a story based on a picture book, which I know a lot of you guys are good at reading picture books. They're my favorite. In an image form, identify key points such as starting point and other vital information. Identify primary muscles. Gosh, man, I must have this way too fast. I was doing 14 things at once. Identify muscles used in the movement. Okay, identify primary muscle used in the movement. Use the website PictoChart or Canva.com. Examples are in Monday's lesson as far as down. Obviously, guys, this is due as of Friday, but it's opened up as of tomorrow. So tomorrow morning, you could turn this in. Okay? Are we good on this? Are there any other questions on this? Are we good? I want everyone, even the ones with their cameras off, to give me a thumbs up if you're good. Give me this reaction emoji right here. Boom. Good, good, good. Okay. Don't wait on this. Get this done. Okay. Get this done after the lesson. All right. Now let's move on. Guys, I have a lot of you, and I don't want anyone to fail my course. So now we're going to spend a lot of time talking about this. I have designed, and granted, guys, a lot of my ideas I take from someone else, but I have designed a holiday move extra credit kind of along the 12 days of Christmas. So if you do one of these movements during the break every day for 12 days, you can earn a total of 49 extra credit points, okay? 49 extra credit points, guys, is basically five Map My Runs, okay? It's basically probably about 5% of your grade in the whole, if not 10% of your grade, okay? If you do all these activities. Now, let me talk about what this is, because I'm not going to explain this every day to you guys because you got to figure it out, okay? So, first thing you got to understand where this is located. If you go to classwork, it's under your holiday move opportunity. Okay, who just left my meeting? I will destroy you. Don't leave my meetings, boys and girls. Okay, enough. Holiday move opportunity, holiday extra credit activities. So I have this cool handy dandy. Okay, let me see your faces because all of you should be smiling right now. Getting into that little spirit. Should I see? Where are you guys at? Hold on. Where is my computer? Hold on, guys.
Is that supposed to be a Christmas party in the gym?
It is. It is, Brian. Okay, now I'll go back to it. Okay. You should all be smiling and laughing and thinking it's the greatest thing ever.
But usually we won't.
Isn't this cool?
Okay.
Okay. So you will see on these a little number, and I have it down here on the Excel sheet too where the numbers are. So you will notice 1 through 6 are due by the day after Christmas. They're all worth different extra credit points. If you go to slide 2, you will see 7 through 12, okay? And they are due the Sunday before we get back. No expectations on this, guys. I did a lot of time putting all the activities in an assignment down here. You will see if you click on these activities, though, it says it's worth no points right here, but it is worth 3, okay? Because I don't want your grade book in to get messed up that way. Okay. So what the activities are, the activities all are different activities you could do at home. You don't even have to go outside. The only one where you probably have to go outside is number 12, and that's 3 Map My Runs due by the end. Now, if you just do 2, you get no extra credit points. You must complete the whole activity in order to get the points, okay? So this, these are not open until the 27th, the second page, but these all are open as of this Saturday for you to do. Okay. And you kind of have a little description of them. Like number 1, the icon's a snowman right here. Number 2, the icon's the elves. Okay. So for example, let's take the elves. The elves is never have I ever fitness. Okay. You must play and you must write a reflection. So what you will do is you'll go to this. Okay. A new little. Another little thing will come up.
Never have I ever for each activity by performing the exercise. Never have I ever gone sledding on a big hill.
So have you gone sledding on a big hill? If you got a yes, what's going to happen? If you yes, you're going to do
if you have gone sledding on a big hill, you're doing push-ups for 30 seconds. Okay? If you have not.
Don't change it. That's the excitement of like the workout is you need to do the workout on there. Okay, so there's a lot of different exercises and stuff you can do on there through it. But let me get back to my thing. But there's all of them have different activities for you to do each day. Okay, so for example, if you were to do, let's pull up a calendar right here. Let's say on the 19th, you were to do number 1, 20th, number 2, 21st, number 3, 22nd, number 4, 23rd, number 5, and 24th, number 6. Then you're off until the following Sunday, okay? And all the activities are basically not over 5 to 10 minutes long, okay? So 2 slides here. When you do it, you turn in different ways. And I have that labeled on here too. So if you look at what you got to do is you got to how to earn your points. A lot of them, you have to write a reflection on it. On three of them, you got to do a flip grid of you doing it. So you'll have your flip grid on while you do it. And those are all set up. Those are worth more points. Those are worth 5 points because you're actually doing it on there. But you'll see all these have an opportunity for extra credit for you to earn 49 extra credit points over the break. Some of you might think, Coach, why are you doing this? I do everything. Okay, I understand you guys do everything. This isn't necessarily to save your guys' grades. Guys, this for me is an opportunity for you guys to move during the break so you don't get complacent. Okay, and all of them are between 5 and maybe 12 minutes max for you to do. Some of them are snowball fights where if you get a snowball thrown at you, you duck. If something comes at you, you jump to the left, jump to the right. Run in place, but none of them require you to go outside except for the run, bike, or walk activity, okay? So again, guys, that's located under holiday extra credit activities. I would suggest you do them. Don't wait till the last minute. It's designed where there's an activity to do every day, 12 days. If you guys look at the whole entire break, you guys basically have 16 days off. Okay, so in those 16 days off, you did 12 activities that obviously could give you Christmas day off, New Year's day off, okay, whatever days you can. It is also designed for you to do it wherever you're at. If you're at aunt or uncle's house, stay in there. Obviously, you could get away and go on your phone and do the activity and Flipgrid it or write a reflection on it and do that. All right, you guys get that? That sound fair? Okay. Hopefully it sounds like, and all the people nodding their heads are people with A pluses right now. I figured that would be. Now, if you have a super duper A plus, guys, do them. But, you know, you probably don't need the extra credit. Do them because you want to stay active and all of that stuff. All right, now let's go through the week so we totally understand what's going on this week with everything that we are doing before we go on this nice little well-deserved break. If we go to week 14 again, guys, today we talked about infographic. We talked about our extra credit activity. Boom, you got infographic to do by this. Right now, what you guys are going to do is you're going to go to your period. So you guys are period 1. Don't go to any other period. Make sure you're on period 1. Okay, when you go to period 1, you're going to be able to put in your thing. So, Sam, you should put your name right here. Okay, so you should put your name in right here. Because I only want 3 people. I change it for you, Sam. Okay? So I only want 3 people doing it per class. okay, per exercise per class. So for example, Coach K already did the squat jumps. So we want to make sure that's not an opportunity when we're squat. There we go. And guys, by no, I do not want you guys copying or anything on those two. So you all need to fill in which one you want to do right here. Is everyone see, right now see my Excel sheet or no? Let's make sure you guys see it. So you got, you could all be on here. Only 3PL max per this. So make sure you go and you fill out which one you want to do. If three people are filled up, that's a bummer. You got to pick a different one. Okay. Hopefully we have all this done by the time all these exercises done. So we have great infographics on there. All right.
Wait.
What, Ryan?
Do we have to do three?
No, you just have to do one.
Oh, that's it?
Okay. Yes. One exercise.
I already did.
What do you mean you already did?
I mean, I typed
Yeah, you're going to do lunges. That's great, Brian.
Okay.
Great. Okay. All right, awesome. Good. Looks like we have good variety. Okay. Hopefully someone picks the bird dogs and the bicep touches and the V-ups. So we have all these exercises taken. I figure from all my classes, I should. All right. And you must be logged in your Powell Unified account to be able to go on here. All right. That's what we're doing today. And then we'll go on to our next day. I hate how if I click on something else, it goes away from my main screen. Okay, and then tomorrow we'll meet, and tomorrow we're going to do our last Moo Mastery on dance. We're going to do the electric slide, guided practice, and then you guys are going to go practice and turn in for your Moo Mastery. Okay, should be fun, should be something you could do at every single wedding you ever go to. That is the last time we are Zooming this week, boys and girls, tomorrow. Okay, Wednesday, you guys are going to do a Map My Run, but you're also going to update your goal sheet. Now, this is something I want you guys to understand. You're going to update your goal sheet with benchmarks, okay? With new benchmarks. Now, I had an example on here. I don't know where I put it, but oh, I put it inside the assignment. So if you click on this, you will see my goal sheet right here. I updated mine this weekend. Okay, so let's talk about the goal sheet real quick, so you guys understand what is expected on this. Well, it's loading. Loading, 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 loading. So you need to have up to benchmark 2 done, okay, on your goal sheet. And I will show you how that looks like as soon as it loads. It's pretending like it's this huge document, which it is a rather genius document, I must say myself. Okay. So this is how your goal sheet should look when you fill it out. Notice I have the top filled out. I have my exercises I picked filled out. I have my starting point, then my goal, and then what I'm going to do here to accomplish this. Okay. We kind of talk about this with your workouts. Your workouts can be added in here. This can constantly be evolving thing. And you notice I did my benchmark number 2. Okay. I basically walked 2 miles in just to say 28 minutes and 12 seconds. I did 44 burpees, which was really hard. I did 61 push-ups, and my form was a little bit struggling towards the end. I would say the last 2 were kind of iffy. I was able to do my yoga for 16 minutes straight. I will tell you, I had too much chaturanga on there, and I did it after my push-ups, so that was rather adventurous. And I checked my schedule for the week, and I was on time, and I added on to this. I did this within a 15-minute ratio of starting it. So let's say, for example, I had on my schedule my class periods. I was always on time for my classes, so that was 100%. But, like, for example, on Saturday for my workout, because I was working out with a friend at the beach, they rescheduled it for an hour later, so that did not fit into the 100% based on that. So I figured I was 80% of my activities on that. So any questions on your goal sheet for the week? Okay. Let's continue on with the week so we understand. And remember, guys, this is always on Monday's lesson is always up for you guys to rewatch if you need to. Okay. Through the rest of the week. So on Wednesday, you're trying to go shoot at my run. On Thursday, this is a big thing, no Zoom, okay? You're basically, guys, going to do the workout you designed last week and the infographic you turned in to me, okay? I was going to have you do this on Flipgrid, but I'm not. And the reason I'm not is because a lot of you had a run in there. You had to go out and do a run at the start. And I don't expect you to carry your phone Flipgridding yourself on that. So you're going to do your self-made workout. When you get back from your workout, you're going to do a reflection. I expect this reflection to be very, very detailed. I don't expect you just to answer these questions. I don't want you to say, rate your workout on difficulty from 1 to 10, you put 3. I want an explanation of why it's like that. I want this to be very detailed. Guys, this is where I turn into a very picky teacher. I reserve the right to give you a 0 on this if I feel like it's just checking the box or feel like you don't didn't do what you were supposed to. There's 5 questions you must answer on here. Okay. One's a 2-part question and I expect them done in detail. Okay. I don't care if you put it on a Word document, do it. I don't care if you type in the text box, but I expect it detailed. Yes, Brian Lou.
Do we need a reason for this?
What do you mean? Do you need a reason for this?
We need a complete sentence. Like you're telling us why.
Yeah, you answer the questions.
Yes.
Yeah. So I guess I don't understand your question, Mr. Liu. But basically, do the workout, okay, and then answer the questions. Okay, so remember last week how when you guys did the workout with me and we did my infographic? Do you guys remember that? Okay, when we did my infographic, okay, When we did my infographic, remember I told you what I thought about the workout that I designed, what changes I might make. That's what I'm looking for. Because when we get back from break, you're going to take these infographics and you're going to put other class members through your workout. So you want to do it first and do any changes you might not have. Now, if you haven't done this assignment, if you haven't turned in an infographic and I'm going to update the zeros when we get done with this class, I'm sorry for you guys. You guys are way behind now. And I don't want to hear some crying story how I'm way behind and I'm stressed out and stuff like that. You still got to get your stuff done, okay? And I use the example of my wrestlers the other day with your parents. Your parents, and I understand a lot of stress happens, they can't go through a day where going, oh, I don't want to raise my kids today. I don't want to do that. You just got to get your stuff done, okay? And guys, I've seen more and more kids fall behind. And the number one thing, and I talked about this in my live talk last week, that's very insulting is when you guys say, I didn't get to my PE because I had too much English homework. That is so frustrating, okay? That's you telling me that I'm not as important as your English teacher, okay? And I will tell you right now, guys, that doesn't fly too well with me. That's whenever you ask me for extra help, I might say, I'm too busy, you know, working with petting my dog, you know, okay? Because that to me is pretty insulting because I have designed the course where everything should be done within the scope of this class, within the time period of this class. Okay, that's the bottom line. Okay, you should not spend over 4 hours a week on this course if you manage your time wisely. All right, I got another I'm on tangent Monday today, guys. I'm very. Okay. Now let's look at Friday this week. So you guys know Friday, Thursday, obviously doing your workout, your infographic workout, turning in your reflection. Friday, you have another Map My Run. Okay. And you turn in the assignment over to infographic on an exercise. Now, I thought of you guys very much this weekend as far as how to make it easier because I did feel a little bad that you guys were confused on what's turning or not. And some of you turn in extra work. I was a little confused. So feel a little bad for you. So I put down here every day what you should be doing. Look at this. Wow, coach, so nice. Okay, every day. Okay, and I put little things. So you can go down here and you can look. Log in every day, 8 a.m. Go, oh, Monday, I have a Zoom. I got to go on Zoom. Oh, I got to do my X ticket. Oh, I got to pick my exercise. from my list under your period. You guys should have already done that right now. You're done with Monday. Now you can start going to work on the infographic after this class if you want. Tuesday, exit ticket. We're doing Zoom, exit ticket, Movement Mastery together, and then you finish your electric slide once you have it mastered. Wednesday, no Zoom. Oh, I don't got Zoom tech. You go on and do my run. Okay, I go do my run. But in the meantime, I need to update my goal sheet with all this stuff, so I got to make sure I have all those done. Oh, so I might want to go do one of my goal sheet benchmarks today. Thursday, no Zoom. Oh, I don't have Zoom today. So I do my workout during at 8 a.m., okay, then I write my reflection. I should be done by about 8:40. Imagine that. Friday, no Zoom, exit ticket. Oh, I go do my mount my run. Oh, I finish my infographic. I'm done for the week. And then I might be a superstar student. I go, oh, wow, Coach Joe offered us extra credit. What a nice person he is. Let me go look at that, make sure I understand that. Oh, boy, okay, boom.
And then we might have the Christmas party in the gym.
Yes, the Christmas party in the gym. Yep, yep. And it's yep, very cool. And then we could go and do these and we could have fun and it'll be great. Okay. All right. Any other questions on that? Now, I understand some of you are injured. Okay, guys. I mean, injuries happen. You still got to do everything you can possible. Okay. If you're able to walk, you can still do a 2-mile walk. If you're not able to walk, then we might have to table that for another time. If you have a doctor's note, go ahead and give me a doctor's note. Send it to me, because I know I have at least two people in my classes that all of a sudden have got injuries in different things. And things like that. You know, I'll give you an example, and I understand you guys aren't my wrestlers. One of my wrestlers gets hurt and they hurt their leg. We make them an ergometer and they're riding the bike with their hands. Okay. Boom, boom, boom. One of them hurts their upper body. They're doing squat jumps and different things like that. So, but I understand you guys aren't all athletes or wrestlers too. So we just got to find a way to get things done, but you can do the infographic, and items like that this week. All right. Any other questions for me? Okay, I apologize for being very direct today, guys. I was very direct because I wanted this recording and I want everything to be fully understand. I didn't want to get on Life Talk method too much today and get you guys off track. I want you guys to understand you have an activity every day to complete. Okay. Follow the Canvas page. Guys, you can look at the calendar from now on because that's up to date and stuff. Guys, but just pay attention, okay? And before you email me, guys, always just look at the Canvas page and tell yourself, do I understand this, okay? And I apologize. Some of you guys have just been emailing one word response back, like on the instructional that you guys had emailed me on that said, no, you don't have to do that. That's for period 3 and 4, okay? Just pay attention to what you got to do, okay? And another way you can look for what you got to do, if you go to my Synergy and you look at the grade book in there, which I'll update the grade book for this week in there, that's what you have to get done to a T. All right. Did you guys like me being more direct or more funny? Put it in the chat. More direct or more funny? Some of you need me more direct. How, my buddy Tommy Childs? Both. Thank you, Grace. Yep, both is good. All right. Good. I'll look at those for sure. All right, guys. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you guys paying attention. I appreciate it. Seems like we got everyone in the class on today. Guys, I'm excited for this week's activity. I appreciate you guys. Hopefully you appreciate the chance for extra credit. You know, the chance for extra credit is also a chance for you guys to move. Some are pretty funny. I did some yesterday, and some were designed for elementary kids. I understand. Like, if you look at some of those videos, like, it's like some like little kid voice saying, hey, let's have a snowball fight, you know, but they're fun and it's an opportunity for you to earn some credit and move around so we don't sit around the whole time. And it's great and it's awesome. And you guys are awesome. So guys, as you go on with your Monday, okay, I'm letting you off by 8:45, which one plan? Make sure you manage your time effectively. Make sure you get what you got to get done, okay? Don't procrastinate on your activities. Guys, I'll tell you, Thursday, I thought about you guys a lot. I did the no Zoom for a couple reasons. One is I'm probably going to be on a plane. But the second reason is I understand this week teachers are test crazy, huh? Give me a thumbs up if teachers are test crazy this week. Yes. I mean, teachers, they treat this week like finals, right? And it's a big talk with teachers to do semester. So I wanted to make sure at the end of the week, I gave you guys a chance to get your stuff. You got to get done with PE. That's the bottom line. It's got to get done. But I also want to make sure you guys have the time to manage your schedule with the workload of your other classes. Okay. So make sure you get that all done. Okay. This is where you say, thank you, Coach Joe. You're the best. You guys see my TikTok when I said, when I talked about when a student says I'm not their favorite teacher and I go, I'm jealous. Yeah. That was one of my better ones. So, all right.
Make you feel sad.
Yeah. Well, you guys have a great day. You guys are awesome. I appreciate you guys. If you have any questions, I'm here for you. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.
Thank you, Coach.
Bye.